Today will be discussed about heating effect of electric current. It is the most important topic for 10th board exam and any types of examination. So today we will discuss about the heating effect of electric current. In the starting of the chapter, we study about electric current, electric charge, electric potential, and the conversion of energy. So, firstly, we learn the energy of electron. The energy of electron stored in any conductor in two form. When the circuit is closed, and second, the circuit is open. If the circuit is closed, the energy of electron transport in the form as electrical energy. What the electric circuit will break down? It means the circuit be open, circuit be off. Then the energy of electron store in the form as potential energy. We have a topic, heating effect of electric current. What do you mean by heating effect of electric current? When the electron flow from a conductor, like AB is a conductor bias. Its electron flow. Then electron flow in conductors, they rub to each other and collide to each other. Then after collision, the form of the energy of electron change in heat energy. And this effect of electron by the help of electron produce heat and conductors is called heating effect of electric current. Clearly, electron flowing towards, then the electron heat out the other charged particles of conductors. Then the particle heat and collide to each other, and after collision, after friction, heat generating conductor bias, and this effect of electric current is called heating effect of electric current. Now we will be discussing about the magnitude of heating effect or energy of electric current. So joules. Joule represent the joule conduct the energy, total energy of current by the help of three rules of joule for heating effect of electric current. The energy of electric current we conduct two times, a common method by the using of Joule's law. So we first study about the Joule's law of heating effect. Joule's law of heating effect of electric current. If AB is a wire, conductor wire, conductor. R is the resistance, AB is the conductor by R is the resistance, and I ampere current flow from it. After T time, it produces H heat in conductor wire. Clearly, if a weak conductor wire R is the resistance and I ampere current flow from this conductor wires, R resistance, I ampere. So, after T times, the current flow during the time period T and produce H heat in this conductor wire. So, we can calculate the total heat energy conduct in this wire by the help of Joule's law of heating effect. First law, the heat produces in any conductor wire is directly proportional to the square of current flow from it. Now I repeat the first law of heating effect of current. The heat produced in any conductor wire is directly proportional to the square of current flow from it. It means किसी भी वायर से जो करंट फ्लो कर रहा है उसी पे डिपेंड करेगा इस वायर में जो हीट जनरेट होता है. तो फर्स्ट लॉ ऑफ जूल्स, इससे द प्रोड्यूसेस हीट इन एनी कंडक्टर इज डायरेक्टली प्रोपोर्शनल टू द हीट, सॉरी डायरेक्टली प्रोपोर्शनल टू द स्क्वायर ऑफ करंट फ्लो फ्रॉम हीट. Also retain producing heat is directly proportional to the I square. Here H the produces heat in the conductor wires and I the current flow from this conductor wires. Here R and T be constant. Here R is the resistance of wire and T is the time period of flow of current. Here, both be constant. Equation number first. Second law of heating effect of electric current. Heating effect of electric current. सेकेंड लॉ क्या है? फर्स्ट लॉ के अकॉर्डिंग से एच डायरेक्टली प्रोपोर्शनल टू द आई स्क्वायर. सेकेंड लॉ प्रोड्यूसिंग हीट इन एनी कंडक्टर वायर इज डायरेक्टली प्रोपोर्शनल टू द रेसिस्टेंस ऑफ वायर. हाँ, रेसिस्टेंस ऑफ एच हीट प्रोड्यूसिंग इन कंडक्टर वायर इज डायरेक्टली प्रोपोर्शनल टू द रेसिस्टेंस ऑफ कंडक्टर वायर. Here, I and T be constant. ऐसे क्या होता है कि यार I और T constant. Third at the starting of this chapter, we will be discuss about the resistance related to the heat. Due to the resistance of any conductor wires for moving the electron, more energy exposed, more energy destroy of electron, the break the space of other charged particles of any atom, any conductor wires. Third law of Joule's for heating effect of electric current produces heat in any conductor wire directly proportional to the time duration of flow of electric current. H is proportional to the time duration flow of current in conductor wires. Equation number 3. Now we get equation 1st, 2nd and 3rd. Equation 1st, 2nd and 3rd. From equation 1st, 2nd and 3rd, we get H is proportional to the I square RT. So H equal to K I square RT. As we know, remove the any constant term, any proportional sign, take a constant. So here, K is a constant. Now, in SI system, yes, the system K is 1. The value of K is 1 because we find the value of K by the using of definition of 1 joule heat. 1 joule heat means if the 1 ampere current flow from 1 ohm resistance wire till 1 second. It means 1 ampere ka current kisi bhi conductor wire, 1 ohm resistance wale conductor wire till 1 second tak flow karega. Then the heat produces known as 1 joule heat. If I equal to 1, R equal to 1 and T equal to 1 and H equal to 1, then K is equal to 1. So put the value of K in equation 4. So H equal to I square R T. It is the value of energy of electric current. Energy of H equal to I square R T. Energy of electric current. The energy of electron stored in any conductor wires as a during the heating effect in the form of I square RT. We can also describe this formula by the using of common methods. We know that potential potential is equal to the work done by charge. At the starting of this chapter, we learn about the transformation of energy, conversion of energy, the potential energy of electron converted in electrical energy, the potential energy of electron converted in heating energy. But the energy of electron, how to change in this order? In this chapter, heating effect, the energy of electron converting heat energy by the help of collision and friction to each other.
here electric potential is equal to the work done by charge. So V is equal to W by Q. So W equal to V into Q. Potential into charge.
We do that. Potential
by the using of Ohm's law. According to Ohm's law, V equal to IR and Q equal to IR. V equal to IR by the using of Ohm's law. Ohm's law and U equal to I. U equal to I because I is equal to,
Q equal to I into T. Because the depletion of electric current, the rate of flow of charge in any conductor is called electric current. So,
Q equal to I. Now we also find I square RT. With a work done.
So the capacity of work done in any substance, any object is called its energy. So W here, W is the energy.
So I equal to I square, H equal to I square RT.
So in the formula of heat energy of electric current, I square RT, we can also find the formula with a common method, use the Joule's law. That's all today. Now, next time I will discuss about the many types of properties of heating effect, heating and electrical appliance that work on the principle of heating effect. So, take care. Please keep the social distance and support the lockdown system. At this time, we all, whole world, struggle the coronavirus. So I request to all of you, support this movement, support the lockdowns and take care. Thanks.